Good morning, everyone. Thursday, February 24th. Look at that. We're just doing this. I could be cheeky and say in 10 months it's Christmas. Yeah. It's Black History Month, and I found another figure to highlight for you. So this is Vernetta Anderson.
My dad, Ezra Sugarfoot Anderson, was brought up to the CFL in the late 40s, early 50s. My mother came up a year or two later and really loved the people that they met, and that's why they decided to stay. She got involved in the community and very early on had an aptitude for bringing people together. It was really those people who said to her, Vernetta, you really should be in city politics. She brought that sense of service and community commitment to politics. People used to approach her and say, well, you know, are you for women's rights? Are you for black rights? And he'd say, I'm for human rights. I believe that if I am true to myself and I am honest and true to the people that I serve, that I will make the best contribution towards eradicating whatever social constraints and barriers and issues there are.
That's a good story and a lot of good people that we need to highlight. Because we are doing the, you know, course promotions and department heads are coming on the show. Of course, it's pre-recorded. Today we'll have tech. Mr. Galley will be, you know, highlighting the courses in the tech department. So I just want to mention a few announcements and to follow up. We've mentioned that beautiful artwork in the cafeteria. Well, let me tell you, they are Miss Paletta's grade 11 and 12 visual art students who did that. And they are inspired by an African-American artist named Lois Mailou Jones. So kudos to your artwork there. And also, you may have noticed that wonderful artwork that Mrs. Person Midgick's Cosmo class did, which is fantastic. So kudos. And just to remind you, today is Team Photo Day. So please, I hope you guys are listening as you, you know, get ready for, you know, class officially. Junior and senior girls field hockey teams and the golf team. You guys are up now. So please make your way down to the gym for your team photo. So that's the junior and senior girls field hockey teams and the golf team. You guys are starting the team photo thing. And just a reminder to those who are writing the math contest, it's happening today during period two in the library. So that's for those of you in grade 9, 10, or 11 who are writing the Waterloo math contest. That's period two today in the library. And of course, Christian meditation was moved from yesterday to today. So if you can, I'll be there in Teams. The link is there in our Teams. Christian Meditation at Assumption is what the team is called on Microsoft Teams. It is grade 11 option sheet presentation today. So the following classes will be in the piazza. Only the following classes. Miss Albert's class, Miss Dorsey's class, and Miss De Silva's class. You're going to the piazza. All other grade 11 classes, please come down to the CAF when you are called down by the main office. And for virtual learners, the grade 11 option sheet presentation is on our main webpage. Teachers, please send a message to your virtual learners so they can watch in period one. So that's team photo day. I'm just trying to catch up. Lunchtime peer tutoring. It is back on Tuesdays and Thursdays in room 104B. If you are in need of a tutor or are interested in becoming a tutor, use the QR codes. But that's Tuesdays and Thursdays, lunchtime peer tutoring. And for grade 9 and 10 students, if you're interested in an opportunity to explore scientific and engineering concepts, you know, for STEAM, come out to the information meeting during your lunch period in room 104 this Friday. All right. I think it's time for anthem, I think. So everyone, please stand for our national anthem.
Canada, our home and strong and free.
Let us remain standing and reverent for our morning prayer and join me in the chapel. I invite you to name any intentions you have in the silence of your hearts, and in a very special way, we pray for the situation in the Ukraine. We pray for peace in our homes, in our hearts, in our homes, in our community, in our country, and in our world. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Loving God, you sent us your only Son because of the unconditional and abundant love you have for each and every one of us. Help us here at Assumption to be instruments of your love and your peace. May all that we do create an atmosphere where every person in this building feels your love, support, guidance, and care through each of our actions. Give us the courage and strength to reach out and respond to your invitation to be peacemakers and people of love. Our Lady of the Assumption, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right. Time for the tech department to talk about their horses. And good morning, everyone. We continue our course promotions with our department heads. I'm here with Mr. Galley. How are you, Mr. Galley?
I'm doing well, thanks. Hi, Miss Sarah. How are you?
I'm good. I'm good. And tell the wonderful students watching, what department you are head of and what are some of the options from your department?
Yeah, I'd be more than happy to. Mr. Galley, I'm the department head for technological education. Some of the courses that we offer, obviously, construction, hospitality and tourism, cosmetology, tech design, computer science, comm tech, computer engineering. I think that's all of them.
That's a good choice.
It's a pretty broad selection for sure.
And so which ones do you want to start with talking about?
I'll just start with the ones that I teach. So I teach communication technology. That course there focuses on animation, graphic design, film production, live television production like this. I also teach computer science, where we focus on mobile app development for iOS. So we just basically create apps for the iPad and iPhone.
Yeah. Nice. Very cool.
Yeah.
Shall I then bring up the video?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, you know what? It's a great segue into our other department members kind of introducing some of the courses that they teach.
Good morning, Assumption. I'm Mr. Costigan, the construction technology teacher. Just wanted to introduce myself. With course selection around the corner, I just wanted to make you guys aware of the potential electives. The shop's a spot where you guys can work with your hands, get a chance to use the equipment, build something, get creative, and have a little bit of fun.
How's it going, everyone? I'm Mr. Palermo, and I teach a course here at Assumption called Tech Design that a lot of people might not be familiar with. So I just wanted to, you know, kind of record this quick clip here to discuss who might be interested in the course and kind of what we do in the course really quickly as well. So if you're interested in architecture at all, maybe interior design, maybe engineering design or construction design, this course might be sort of right up your alley to kind of give you some experience in designing and 3D modeling. But not just that, I mean, even if you're, you know, if you want to tap into your creative side a little bit and design some solutions to some challenges and problems, then this course might also be for you. And what we do is every project, it's a project-based course, and every project we take on starts with a problem or a challenge of some sort, and we follow kind of a systematic problem-solving approach. We call it the design process, to eventually sketch some ideas and then use 3D modeling software to model our ideas. And then what I also love about this course is we take our 3D model and we try to build prototypes after to test if our solutions are a viable option or not. So we have a CNC machine where we can carve out of wood, and I have four 3D printers here in the classroom where we can, you know, create parts out of plastic as well. So we could take our models and actually bring them to life using these machines. It's offered in grade 10, 11, and 12. In grade 10, it is an open level course, and in grade 11 and 12, they have the M letter to it, where it's mixed college or university, so it's also a university credit. So what you'll see next is some projects that students worked on, and you'll see a slideshow of them. It's just some of the projects. There are a lot that we do work on, and hopefully something there maybe excites you to maybe want to take the course.
My name is Ms. Person Midgick. I teach the cosmetology classes and hospitality and tourism. If you wanted to take Cosmo in grade 9, it's a split class, half Cosmo, half foods, right? So you get a little bit of taste of each course. Grade 10 and 11 and 12 are separate. So if you want to learn how to do an updo, some braids, some nail designs, makeup, or do anything with the play that is coming up, hopefully we can do hair and makeup for that, come take Cosmo. And if you want to take foods, today we made hot chocolate cups. So whatever you make, you get to eat. We do breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and some desserts. Hope to see you soon.
That was very cool.
Yeah, definitely a lot of different opportunities for sure to get some hands-on experiential learning.
Yes, I'm sure some of the kids are excited now. So if they have questions, where can they find you or members of the department?
Yeah, so any member of the department, whether it's Mr. Palermo, Mr. Roberts, Mr. Costigan, Ms. Persimidzic, Ms. Horn, or myself, you can just pull us aside and ask any questions you may have about any of the tech offerings we have here at Assumption.
Well, thank you so much, Mr. Galley, for your time. And for those of you, good luck with your course options. And remember, option sheets are due March 7th. Take care, everyone, and take care, Mr. Galley.
Thanks. Bye.
And just a reminder, the classes going for their option sheet presentation today, the grade 11 classes, the following three classes are in the piazza: Miss Albert's class, Mrs. Dorsey's class, and Mr. Silva's class. All other grade 11 classes, please wait to be called down to the CAF by the main office. Take care, everyone.